Plus, the promise of never chasing another paycheck again. Wouldn't that be nice? Financial expert Dr. Robert Watkins joins us live with tips on how to finance your future and ignore your credit score. Nearly 80% of American workers say they are living paycheck to paycheck, and that means 4 out of 5 of us are more focused on a payday than a financial goal or dream.
Our next guest says we all need to stop focusing on credit scores and come up with 7 different streams of income. Dr. Robert Watkins is the CEO of Conquer Worldwide and author of Never Chase the Paycheck Again, Powerful Lessons to Finance Your Life. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Thank you for being here. 80% of Americans living paycheck to paycheck. So when you talk about, you know, what are misconceptions about wealth or how to become wealthy, I think many people go, well, it's impossible if you're living paycheck to paycheck, right?
Well, most people don't have a money problem. They have a management problem.
Okay.
You remember Adrian Peterson? He plays in the NFL.
Mm-hmm.
He's made over $100 million over his career, but it was just reported that he's in deep debt. So he doesn't have a money problem or an income problem. He has a management problem. And I'm discovering in my company that many people just don't know how to manage what they have. We can turn a little into much when you understand management principles of money.
You mean like budgeting and that sort of thing?
Yes, absolutely.
You also talk in your book about creating 7 streams of income.
Yeah.
How do people do that?
Well, most people think when I talk about 7 streams of income, they're thinking I'm talking about 7 different businesses, which can be overwhelming. But I'm talking about having one idea, one business, one thought, and creating 7 streams of income around that one idea. For example, if you're a baker, for example, you can have speaking engagements, you can have a catering company, you can do classes, you can create a YouTube channel, monetize it, you can sell your recipe and you can have in-store type of sales. So those are just a few income streams around one central idea in your life. It could be one business idea or just one thought.
Yeah. What if someone, they say, oh, I work at an office and I file paperwork or I do, you know, these tasks. What can I do with that?
Yeah. Well, I have something called PLAN, right?
Okay.
P-L-A-N. It's a good way to understand it. Number one, prioritize your return on investment.
Okay.
I'm a professional speaker. I don't even buy a pair of shoes unless I have a return on investment. So I treat my money like a business.
Okay.
The L is to list your talents and skills outside of your 9-to-5. So if you are a waitress, for example, and people ask you to come to organize their closet, maybe that's a business.
Mm-hmm.
The A is to apply my 10-10-10 strategy, which is invest 10%, give 10%, and save 10%. Most people say, I can't do that. You can do that regardless of your income. And the N, finally, is never stay where you're not valued.
Mm.
Most people stay on the job, they stay in relationships, or in situations where they're not being valued.
Mm. One of the things you also talk about is, you know, we're preoccupied with what is our credit score, and you think that's a bad idea.
Well, we need to stop obsessing about credit scores. You know, banks, they want you to get into their system of credit scoring. Most people, when they deal with trying to get a new car, a new house, the banks will ask you this.
Yeah.
What are your assets minus your liabilities equals your net worth? That's not your real net worth. They're trying to figure out what is your discretionary income, but real wealth builders have a different formula that doesn't require credit, and that is what you owe minus what you own minus what you owe equals your real net worth.
Mm-hmm.
And once you understand that, then credit score really doesn't matter.
But it is depressing when you find yourself looking at it and you go, well, no one's going to, you know, lease me a car or I can't buy a house. What
maybe,
is it?
Maybe it's better, though, huh?
Right. Just,
I
just
get
ignore
into
it.
Debt.
Yeah.
Well, having an asset is, it's not a real asset if you owe money on it.
Yeah.
It's really
yeah.
not an asset.
Yeah.
So the banks want to know discretionary income. How much money do you have left at the end of the month?
Mm-hmm.
Well, we'll take that.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I'm trying to get people away from. In our company, we major on you becoming an owner.
All right.
Yeah.
Once again, Dr. Robert Watkins, an author, financial expert, and CEO of Conquer Worldwide. If you go to the website neverchasethepaycheckagain.com within the next 24 hours, you can get his 9-step blueprint system for free. Use the code word KTLA. You'll get immediate digital access to his ebook and video training. Thank you, Dr. Watkins, for coming.
It was my pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.